Assalamu alaikum. Well, this is the time that we go ahead and install our Laravel backend. If you're following along with me, come to this link and click over here and download the code from GitHub link, and I have already did. Now we'll see how to install it. Well, the condition is that before you go ahead and install this Laravel application, you have to install at least PHP and Composer on your machine. Maybe it's Mac, Windows, or Linux, doesn't matter. And if you know how to do that, follow these two tutorials based on your requirement and go up to where you install Composer. And after installing Composer, we'll take it from there. But of course, you can go ahead and install the whole Laravel application, but this Laravel is not the one that I'm using. I mean, this is the actual one, bare. There's nothing inside, so I have edited a lot, so you want to follow along with me, not really this one. So go ahead and just install up to Composer. Make sure that your PHP and Composer has been installed correctly. Okay, all right, so go ahead and click on this, and you should be able to download the link and the code. Go ahead and I did it, and after that I'll come to my download folder, which is this one, and I'll move it to my document folder. You can move it anywhere you want, it doesn't really matter. Now here I'll do clear. Now I'll go to my documents folder, okay, because this is where I put my zip file. Now here I do see that I have this one, okay. All right, so here I would do unzip shopping app. All right, now here I would clear, and I would do here ls, and with this I'll go to this folder inside. Okay, now I would go to cd shopping app main. Now here I do see a few things. So over here I see my zip file for this is the actual Laravel backend, and this is the SQL. Okay, so here we see this too. Okay, now here if you're on Mac, so just open up your folder if you want to follow along with me. Now I'll come inside and I'll double click on it, and it'll unzip it. Okay, now after unzipping it, I'll do ls. Now I'll remove mbs.tar, we don't need that, and we'll clear it. Let me go ahead and close this one. Now here I am. So we have this too. Now I'll rename it. So I would do MBS and shopping app. Okay, all right. Now we'll have this too. Now we can go inside shopping app. All right. Now here I see that I have this things over here, okay. Now one thing is happening over here. It's missing server.php. Every Laravel application comes with server.php, but when you move a certain application from one server to another, a lot of time or the files are missing or they get missed. In our case, we are missing server.php. Now you could Google Laravel server.php missing, come over here, and over here we'll see that we have server.php. okay, now we'll copy this code. All right, after that we'll come over here and I will do vim server.php. it'll create a new file, empty file for me, and open it, and I'll paste it. Okay, and after that I'll do, let's see, okay, now then I'll do wq to save it, and then we do ls. And after doing ls, I see that server.php is here. Now I would do php artisan serve. Now here I see that I have a composer that detected php version is mismatching. In that case, I would run composer update and it should fix the problem, and it may take a bit of time. All right, okay, we're good. Now, after doing this one, we see we can do server dot serve artisan PHP artisan serve, and we'd be able to go ahead and open it. So let's go ahead and put it there. Now we see that this is the front end of the Laravel application, that one we downloaded, but yet we can't go to the back end for now because we need to connect our database to it. Well, now for now, what I would do, I'll come over here and I'll go inside this one, and this is where our application is living. Now I'll open this up in VS Code. And after that, I'll go to this env file and I'll remove these things. This was test data. Now over here we need to put things, so we need to put our database name and password. Okay, now to be able to work with this database on your machine, regardless you are using Mac or Windows, you should have to have MySQL installed. And once you have installed MySQL, you should upload this database, which is the one we have, the one we have seen over here. Let me close this for now. So I would step back, I would do clear ls. So we have to upload this one to our MySQL database. Okay, now regardless whatever machine you have to install MySQL. Now over here, I'm on Windows, I'm on Mac. Now I'll show you how to install MySQL on Mac, but for Windows followers, please follow this tutorial. It'll show you how to install MySQL, okay? If you have already installed, that's great. Now for Mac users, we'll do one thing. Now here we'll come over here, we'll do Google, and we'll do MySQL. All right, so I'll click on this and then I will go ahead and download this one. Okay, once you download this one, it would ask you to go ahead and install it. If you double click on it and just click next, and you have to type in your MySQL username and password. In this case, pretty much you should use username as a root and password whatever the password you go ahead and set it up. But once you install this MySQL, and if you come over here, you should be able to see MySQL over here in your system settings. And if you double click on it, it'll see that it's already running. If it's not running, click start MySQL server. Okay, so with this you should be able to run your MySQL. Okay, and once you are done, you can also do MySQL version, see the version you have, version. Okay, all right, anyway, so here we are. Okay, now we need to upload it to our database, and to be able to upload it, first we need to go ahead and create a database in MySQL. Okay, so I will do MySQL minus u root. This is the username, the one you just set up, and the password. Now the password you need to type in when you install the software, that one. So here I would type in my password. Okay, here we are, and here we would create a database. We do create database Laravel shopping app. You can name it whatever you want, okay? It doesn't really matter, okay? All right, now let's see. Create database Laravel shopping app. Maybe it doesn't support hyphen, it does support underscore, okay? Do it, yes, done. All right, so now we'll see show databases. So here we see Laravel shopping app. Okay, now once you're done with this, you will come over here and set up it. Set up the database name, which is Laravel shopping app. And here username was root. Okay, and password, whatever the password you set up. Username is whatever the username you're using, okay? In my case, I use this password, and after that, I'll save it. And then you do exit over here, and we'll clear it. And over here we are. Now we need to upload this SQL to this one, okay? I'll copy this one. Now I'll come over here, and I'll run this one more time, and then I'll write my database name, which is this one. Now after that, I'll have this slash on Mac or Linux, it doesn't matter. And after that, I would do this one, and then I would go ahead and find this directory, okay, and this folder. So I know that this is in my documents folder in my shopping app backend, all right? And inside this, I have this shop app DBSQL, okay? So this is the path where your database right now, and this is where you will upload in the system, okay? So now here we would hit enter, and it would ask you to use the password, and with this we are done. It should be uploaded there, okay? All right, once it is done, now we'll over here refresh our app, okay? And let's see what happened. Okay, I need to go inside my shopping app, and I do PHP artisan serve. Okay, now over here I'll rerun it, it's live. Now going to the back end of our Laravel application, we just simply type admin, okay? Oh, looks like it's missing a lot of information. Let's see what's happening here. Unsupported. Okay, now here this is SSL problem. Now here for this one, just remove this, and as well as here, instead of writing this, go ahead and write HTTP localhost, okay, and save it. All right, but you can also mention the port number if you want, it doesn't really matter. Okay, localhost, okay, and now go ahead and refresh it. Here we are. Okay, now in general, when you log in first time, you should see this page where you type in admin as username and password is also admin, then login, and inside you will have these things, okay, where you have food category, users, food dashboard, things like that. So later in the tutorial, we'll see how to work on this backend. Thank you.